So, hello students. Today we will discuss a problem on finding out the velocity, okay, linear velocity as well as angular velocity of a given mechanism using instantaneous center method. Instantaneous center method. So this is the given problem here. So in a pin jointed four bar mechanism as shown in figure, AB is equal to 300 millimeter as you can see here. BC is equal to CD is equal to 360 millimeters and AD is equal to 600 millimeters. So angle BAD is given as 60 degrees. The crank rotates, the crank A, okay, the crank AB rotates at 100 RPM. So speed of the AB is given, rotation speed of the AB is given. So locate all the instantaneous centers and find the angular velocity of the length BC and velocity of C. So let us take down the given data, that is AB is equal to 300 millimeter, BC and CD are 360 millimeters. AD is equal to 600 and angle BAD is equal to 60 degrees. So NAB or speed of AB is equal to 100 RPM. So let us find out the angular velocity of the crank AB. So it is given by 2 pi NAB by 60. So when you input the data 100 RPM here, so you will find out the omega AB, that is 10.47 radians per second. Okay, so now let us move on to the next step, that is constructing a configuration diagram or space diagram. Okay, so for that, what we'll do is we'll take the scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 100 millimeter. Okay, then the dimensions will become 3 centimeters, 3.66 centimeters. Okay, for the respected links, for the respective links given. Okay, now draw the configuration diagram using the given dimensions. So AD is the fixed length. So that is 6 centimeters, that measures 6 centimeters. So let us draw a line for 6 centimeters. Then consider AB, so that is 60 degree. Okay, that is BAD, angle BAD is equal to 60 degree. So now construct AB for 3 centimeters. Now from C measure 3.6 and from D measure 3.6. Okay, use a compass. Okay, measure 3.6 using the compass and cut an arc from C as well as from D. You will get a point and using that point join C and D. So now we have 4 links, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Our next intention is to locate the instantaneous centers. So before doing that, we need to know, okay, how many instantaneous centers do we have in the given mechanisms? So for that, we have a formula, correct? So that is the instantaneous center is given by n into n minus 1 divided by 2. Number of instantaneous centers, capital N, is given by small n into n minus 1 divided by 2. So here in this case, 4 links are there. Therefore, the instantaneous center will be 6. Okay, so now once you find out how many number of instantaneous centers are there in the given link or in the given mechanism, so you can list the instantaneous centers to be found out. So 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, and 3, 4 are the 6 instantaneous centers we need to allocate. Okay, so now let us see how many instantaneous centers do we have, okay, or we can locate using the given mechanism. So first of all, let us consider link 1 and 2. So the instantaneous center will be I12 because both the links will rotate at that particular point, or link 1 is fixed or frame. So 2 will rotate about that particular point. So it will be 12. So when I consider 23, it will be instantaneous center I23 at that point, at point B. Sorry, there is a mistake here. Or anyways, so I23, then I34 and I14. So let us tick the obtained or located instantaneous centers first. Okay, next we can find out or locate the unknown instantaneous centers 1, 3, and 2, 4 using a circle method as we have discussed in the theory class. Okay, so let's draw a circle and mark 4 points with respect to the links. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, join all of them. So once you join, now we need to find out the instantaneous center 1 and 3. 1 3. Okay, so join 1 3 or draw a diagonal. So as you can see, 1 3 is covered by two triangles on both the sides. One is 1 2 and 2 3. 1 2 and 2 3, as you can see here, this is 1 2 and this is 2 3, and another one is 1 4 and 4 3. See, 1 4 and 4 3 or 3 4. Okay, so now using this data, what we can do is we can extend, see, 1 2 and 2 3, both of them lie in the same line. Okay, so you can extend this line as well as 1 4 and 3 4 also lie in the same line. So therefore you can extend this line also. So wherever both the lines intersect, you will obtain the instantaneous center 1 3. Instantaneous center 1 3. Now let us talk about another instantaneous center to be found out, that is 2 4, or located, that is 2 4. So 2 4, when I draw a line from 2 to 4, or when I join 2 to 4, so it is also covered by two triangles on both the sides. One is 1 2 and 1 4. Okay, see here, 1 2 and 1 4, both of them lie on the same line. Okay, another one is 2 3 and 3 4. So both of them lie on the same line. So extend line from AD and extend a line from CD. Okay, so that you will obtain the remaining instantaneous center, that is 2 4. So now you can locate 2 4. So it is going out of the frame. So that is why, anyways, in your paper, you can select a smaller scale and you can do the, or find the, or locate the instantaneous center. So once it is done, so what is the next step you need to do? You need to find out the angular velocity of the given link, as well as you need to find out the velocity of the given point, that is C, velocity of C, correct? Angular velocity of link BC and velocity of C. So for that, we know what to do. In the theory class, we have discussed about the relation. So omega BC will be equal to, okay, so omega BC will be equal to VB divided by, see, for BC, see, these are the two, sorry for inconvenience again. So 1 3 is the common instantaneous center. So therefore VB by I13B is equal to VC by I13C. So measure I13B and I13C from the configuration diagram. So doing that, so omega BC will be equal to 3.14 divided by the measured value of the I13B, that is 0.52. So that, so when you calculate it, the value of omega BC will be equal to 6.04 radians per second. Now what you can do, you can use the value of omega BC in order to find out VC. So omega BC will be equal to VC by I13C. So VC is the unknown value. So cross multiply omega BC into I13C. So that is, see, measure I13C. So once you measure that, you'll get the value as 0.39, I think. Yes, 0.39. So 6.04 into 0.39 will give you the value, that is 2.35 meter per second. So this is how we need to calculate the angular velocity as well as the velocity for the given point or for the given link using instantaneous center method. So whatever the links are, I mean, how much, you don't worry about the number of links. Okay, you just calculate the number of links and find the intersection so that, okay, both the ICs lie in the same line, because we have learned the Arnold theorem. Okay, and we know that the, okay, if the body is in motion, if three bodies are in motion with respect to each other, all the three ICs will lie in the same line. Okay, so here, so this is how the solution will be made. So in the next class, we will be discussing about the same type of problem, that is finding the velocity, as well, angular velocity as well as linear velocity for a given slider crank mechanism. Slider crank mechanism. So thank you, students.